This is Ashwin again. In this video tutorial, we are going to see the usage of finally block in Python programming in exception handling. So in the earlier video, we saw how to raise the exceptions explicitly in our code. So let's actually continue with the same piece of code. I have just deleted the line which explicitly raises an exception. So this is a very simple code. So let us try to execute it and see what is the output of this code. Okay. So here a equal to 1 and b equal to 0. So whenever I'm going to calculate the value of c by saying a divided by b equal to c, then this is surely going to raise an exception. Let us execute this piece of code. Okay, it says now error division by 0, okay, which is supposed to be the expected output of the code. Now if I change the value of b to 1, it is going to execute the else block, right? So when I'm going to say run, it says it did not encounter any exception. Okay, so whenever I'm going to use this sort of situation, that whenever I have some sort of exception, then it is going to be handled by except block, and whenever there is no exception at all, it is going to be handled by else block. Okay. So, but I want a piece of my code to be always executed irrespective of whether there is an exception or not in my code. So for that, there is a provision in Python. That clause is known as finally. Okay. So it is the part of our exception handling facilities in Python. So we just say finally print, and this block of code is always executed. This block is always executed. So naturally, you can actually always replace this print statement with your own custom statements, whatever you want to have, when execution of all the statements under the try statement is done. Okay, so now let us enable the let us disable the exception first. Now the exception is disabled. These three lines, they are not actually going to throw any sort of exception. So now let's run this. Okay, so our interpreter did not encounter any exception, and this block is always executed. Statement is also printed. So let's see what happens when there is an exception. Okay, so now we have introduced a code which is going to raise an exception in the code. Okay, so let us run it. Okay, now it reads, now the first line of the output reads error division by 0, and the second line is this block is always executed. Now as you can see, the difference is that it is actually choosing the block accordingly. Okay, so whenever there is an exception, it chooses to execute the except block, and whenever there is no exception, it chooses to execute the else block. But as you can see, the finally block is always executed irrespective of whether there is an exception encountered in the program or not. Okay, so that is the main purpose of finally block, to execute always the statements, okay, which are supposed to be executed after the termination of entire program. Okay, so if any one of you have worked with the programming languages like C++ and Java, so even C++ and Java have got, I guess not C++, but the Java has got this finally clause in the exceptional block in the exception handling routine. Okay, so this is actually similar to that, very very much similar to that. The only thing is the only different thing is the syntax. Okay, we have just written all the stuff in the Python in the syntax of Python programming language. So this is how we use finally block to always execute the block of statements after having done with our exception handling routine. Thanks a lot for watching my video. In case you have any query related to the code or the concept, you just let me know in the comment section down below for this video, and do not forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel for more exciting videos on Python. Thanks a lot. Have a nice day.